And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Building Projects. Since we last left off, a lot of stuff has happened. Unfortunately, that's because the last two episodes, I forgot to switch on the microphone. Lots of stuff has happened. Biggest thing that has happened, I've decided to not continue building into that mountain, but leaving it as the prison that it is. Maybe I'll lock up some zombie villagers in there. And I've kind of decided to build around this lake here. I built this little shack there, the fisherman's shack. I built a pathway towards it, or I guess coming from it. Anyway, in any way you want to look at it. Here we go. I just used some cobble here to kind of build the support structure. And then some planks on top to finish her off. The roof has a little overhang over the windows, just because I thought that would be that could look nice. I used some different types of stone as well. Then the support, trunks here, the pillars here, for the original structure. I left them in the roof because I think that gives it a more, a more kind of old look, which is what I was going for. It doesn't have an interior yet. It will. We'll make a different episode where I do that. And then of course this also has now the doors a little bit comes in a little, and then here there's a place that comes in. There's a little nook here, just because I wanted to make sure that it didn't look perfect and smooth. I just wanted it to look like, yeah, someone lives here and there's some stuff that goes on here. And then here a little dock where you can throw out your fishing line and just get on fishing. I'm trying to grow a dark oak tree here, but it's not working. So we might also build our own custom tree there. And then over here, I've started a farm. We have some potatoes and we have some wheat. I do have carrots in the storage room, and there are pumpkins growing behind our little house there. And I also found melons, so we have pretty much every type of food available to us. Then here I have some sheep that I'm breeding. I started out with 3, now there's a lot more. Some cows, I started with 5, now there's also a lot more. That's what I've been doing. I got some cactus as well, and started a little farm. I'm not sure if it's working as well as it could. It's probably not so efficient, but it's good enough for me. We don't need a lot, but it's nice to not have to look for it. It's just in a chest there under the water. I noticed that most of the cactus falls on the edge there, which is fine. It can despawn there. Now this little cage I made for some chickens potentially, because I got a few eggs. I threw them at the ground and none of them popped out at baby chickens, so I'll have to look for them again and hopefully get one. But yeah, that's kind of what I've been up to. Today I thought it would be we could have some fun by building a farmer's house here, maybe. Because I this whole area used to be like that. As you notice, there's no real real grass there. No, like, what do they call this? Yeah, just grass. Because I dug this all out and replaced it with dirt. Because this was all stone, I replaced it with dirt and just to make it a little easier to build on. But yeah, I think that worked out pretty well. It doesn't really look like it's man-made. If I would have put the grass there, it would look like it's just real, like it's just the generation there, and that's what I was going for. So I'm pretty happy with that. But yeah, I wanted to make a little farmer's house. I'm not sure if it's going to be a farm or a sheep or cow farm. But for now, I'm thinking probably more like a little petting zoo with sheep and some cows. And then later, maybe some chickens. That will all be in the same cage, in the same same little area. And then the cows and the sheep that we're going to use are going to be somewhere else. So yeah, I'll just go grab the materials for that, and I'll be right back. So I found the materials. Here we go. Lots of different stuff, and you probably weren't expecting so much stone. But the stone is actually the same as there. It's for the base of the structure. Because I want to stay kind of within the same... I want to stay within the same design. And the roof might be... We might change up the roof a little. But for the most part, it's gonna be just like this, just like the little fisherman's hut that we built. I'll just make a bed here to get some sleep. We're gonna be using beds anyway, so might as well. Let's sleep real quick, and we'll get started. Yeah, I'll just leave it there for now. Let's see. So let's start again with the pillars to kind of figure out an area. I'm thinking if we go here, and here, and just pillar that up, that could potentially make for a very nice structure. It doesn't need to be extremely large. I mean, why would we make it extremely large? There's no need for that. So, I think it's probably more beneficial to make it high, instead of making it, making the base very big. This might even be, pretty big already. So maybe we cut this down and replace it to here, and then this can also come in two blocks. That's probably even better. And then we'll just make two stories in the building. Let's make it four high for now, and we'll make it higher, of course. So let's see, the ceiling would be at this height for the first floor. Oh, let me grab some dirt. I'll be right back. So if we build up here, to just add five more, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can't reach that from here. So let's just build out to there. 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is approximately how tall I'd like it to be. Yeah. And then on the second floor, we'll have some hay bales. We'll have some hay bales scattered around here. But that's all extra. So let's start off with the base of the structure. And I like to just line it in cobblestone first, and then replace some of the cobblestone with other blocks, just so it's not bland and the same all the time. So let's see, three and two, and then here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, so this will be 2, 1, 3, 2, something like that, maybe even the other way around, just so we don't have the same texture twice. Yeah, that could be good. And then this goes 1, 2, 3, 4 as well. And this goes 1, 2, 3, 4. And this needs to come in one. So that's 1, 2. Let's see, 2, 3, 1, 2. And then 3, 2, 3. Yeah, and then we'll make the door here, so these can be knocked out for now. Just make the door just right there, and let's see. And then we just go up in these planks here, like that. Whoops. And then we have our wall for the first floor. And now that we have the cobblestone there, you can take it out with a pickaxe. Let's see, take out that. And just replace it with like a stair there, just to add some depth. Take this out and replace that with with andesite. And then this can be some diorite in the mix. And then right here we'll throw some polished andesite. There, and then up here goes the stone bricks. Here we go. And the stone bricks are really so that that really adds more structure to the build. That makes it look like a solid build. If you just add some stone bricks to your building, just here and there, that really adds a lot of structure to them. They'll start feeling like a more solid building. And then here we can go 1, 2, 3, 4. And here we'll add that. And then we have just a block of andesite there. And if we take some distance, that starts looking a little better. Let's grab these two, stone and andesite. Yeah, just add some interest. And now we can see, let's see how are we gonna make the stairway. I'm thinking of going, this is what I'm thinking. Let's use dirt for that, just so we know what it's gonna look like. What am I thinking? This can go away. You can go. Hang on. This goes there. This goes there. This goes there. This goes there. Then this goes here. And then this goes there. We have two under that. we'll make that into a slab. Then this goes here, this goes here. There we go. And we're up.
Right?
So we just have like a little... Oh, that doesn't work, does it? So this goes there. So so we have a round little stairway there. Now here's the problem. It takes up a lot of space. A lot of space. Like if I... Because there's going to be a... Oh, wait a second. We could put a slab there. It's not too bad, actually. Let's see. Let's make a few slabs. Let's see, one up there. One right there, and then we can still be under that. Oh, that's good. It's actually pretty good. Okay. One right there. One right there. And then there we go. I like that. That's good. That's not bad. Let's make a... No, let's leave the interior for later. And then, let's see. I'll just make the second floor... out of slabs. Little whistle there. And then right there, and then let's make some more. Let's sleep real quick. And let's have a few more slabs. And then I think that's it. That's all I can manage. Although, maybe, can we add one there? No. Too bad. Maybe we could add one right there. Yeah, that works. Okay, that's good. Although, do we want that? Not really. We'll just leave it like that. And then with the cobblestone wall, we can add a pillar in the middle of the stairs. And then connect these up. And that starts looking, also from the inside, it starts looking a little more quaint. Don't you think? Put some blocks there. Right. And then we can actually put a chest under here. So we have, and then maybe a door here, so we have a little closet. Let's see if we can do that. Make a chest. Whoops. That's not how we make a chest. Grab some dark oak door. Let's see. Chest there. The door there. We have a little closet. If we take this out and put some cobble under that. Yeah. There's our closet. I think that's cool. I'm leaving that. And then let's grab some more dark oak. And let's finish out the rest of the build, the rest of the walls. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4.
6.
All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. And then we'll start working on the roof. Let's finish out this first. Just like that. And then I saw a slab hanging there. Oh no, this is the slab. So that's fine. And then we'll grab some oak wood to put over the door or doors. And I think we'll use oak doors because I think they look better, they have a better contrast with the dark oak. So just like that, and the doors will be open for now. You can just walk, so you can just walk in, and that's fine. But let's start building our roof here. What are you two doing there? What are you doing there? Okay, let's try that again. 1, 2, 3. Is that right? I think that's right. Yeah, that's right. Of course he's right. So let's see, I want it to stay in the same style. So we'll just make the overhang first. Right there. There. There we go. Just a workbench. Put that there for now. I have some slabs. Make that jump. Yes. Whoops. That's not where you go. Try not to fall off the build. That would be a good thing. Okay, there we go. And then what we need is some stairs. Take the workbench out now and then put the stairs right there, put a slab there, and just kind of alternate slabs and stairs just so that the roof isn't plain. Okay, here's the roof, it's just a straight line and here you go. You want to try to work it a little. There we go. So this is three stairs in a row. I don't like that look. And although this is a very tall building, and you're not going to see much of that from the ground, you might see it if you walk out there. You might see the roof. And I want to make sure that the roof looks, I guess, the same as everything else. I want to have the roof look kind of old and worked. Let's see. Yeah, we can't do that. So we'll just do this for now. And then we'll add in a slab there. And we'll put a slab there, add stairs here. Does that work? Oh yeah, that works. We'll add in another slab there. Some stairs right there. And then we have to add that one. Let's see here. Another slab. More stairs. Yeah, that works. Slab. And slab. And then we grab our workbench. Make some more slabs, make some more stairs. Take you out. Let's see. There we go. And there we go. All right, and that's our roof. Now let's jump let's jump down. We have an empty bucket, so that's good. All right, here we go. Oof. Okay. Let's head up here. Dig out the dirt. And then, of course, we need some more torches. Is my brightness right? Yeah. For now, we'll just use the torches. See, now if we walk... If we were to walk here, the roof still looks nice. It still looks like, yeah, it still looks like it's been there for a while. Let's see. Yeah, let's leave the doors open just so the zombies don't break them. And of course, we need this to be open as well. I'm just thinking of the interior here, and that will kind of translate to the exterior. Because we want some hay bales in here. Whoops. And I think we're gonna need some more dark oak stairs, like that. Let's see. So if I now put you there. I want to make sure that you can see the hay bales in there from outside. And for that, we need a little hole in the wall. Yeah. Yeah, that could look good. Let's see. I see something burning there. Oh, it's a zombie. There's another one. You're dead. Any XP? No. Hey, zombie. You're dead. So yeah, that's how I like to build a little farmer's house. Probably next episode we'll get into the interior stuff. Although, maybe... Let's see. Yeah, I'm thinking next episode we'll work on the interior stuff for both of these buildings. And, so yeah, I will see you guys there. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like. Helps me out a lot. And I will see you guys next time.